everyone through maybe things that they've seen over the past few months in terms of the specific areas that the WASH Working Group we have identified within what is the broader research agenda of the GTFCC, in terms of areas that we are hoping with our partnerships we can get some research, and then we'll have a quick update about the recent call that came out around WELCOME and DFID. So in July 2018, sorry, sometimes I forget we're in 2019 still, there was a meeting convened by WELCOME, Trust, and DFID in London. So all of the working group leads were at that meeting, along with GTFCC, as well as different colleagues from different research institutes and those really involved. So for example, oh no, Christine Marie, you were not there.
No,
so let's see, who was there? Tom was there, who's out there? Tom, you were there, Danielle was there, and
Lauren
was also there. So yeah, I'm not missing anyone. So basically the idea was really to talk about more broadly as GTFCC, where are we going with our research agenda? And then what are the pieces that all of the different working groups or the pillars can bring into that? And there, so there was a two good days of discussion where we all kind of gave, in terms of working groups or pillars, the priorities that we had identified. But when we saw that across all of the pillars, we started to see that there was a lot of commonalities. And so actually what we said was, you know, maybe we need to look at it not across pillars, but at pre-implementation, implementation, and post-implementation /M&E phase. Because what we started to see, there was quite a bit of overlaps. So there was some key components or key areas that we knew we needed to dig further into. So the around burden of disease and identification of hotspots. So again, there I'm not going to go through each small bullet point, but you know, there's WASH came up. It's a lot around transmission, what we were speaking about this morning. And then we also went further into discussing the need to focus more on transmission dynamics. So around the more macro level analysis, the laboratory work, but then also what happens at the community and the household level and the human-to-human transmission or the environmental reservoir, and as well things that need to be done for modeling to be able to do predictability for short-term outbreak. So those are some areas there that were identified needing to have more emphasis for research. Then for implementation, we were really thinking about, okay, the packages. So this is what we've been talking about. What is really that recipe? What are we really needing to do from the different pillars? And as you can see there, the third bullet point down is around WASH package. So what is it that we need to be doing in the short term, the medium term, and the long term? And Danielle did touch upon that this morning. I'd worked on this little diagram one time to talk about sustainable, where we're trying to get, and I know I'd shared it with the Secretariat. I've given that to her because it's kind of the idea of, you know, stop transmission, control, and elimination, and that's kind of the same trajectory that we want to go in. We talked about the importance of having, sorry, behavior change is a little bit just out there on its own. There's not a lot of sub-bullets, but that yes, behavior change is huge, and it's a part of what we need to be having more evidence based on. Operational research on OCV, and then I think the piece below, really the synergies of interventions between OCV and WASH, and we're actually going to speak about that in the next session because we have some updates from collaboration with the OCV working group. We also were looking at post-implementation and M&E, so really how are we measuring effectiveness, how are we particularly around the behavior change and the risk communication, community engagement, all the pieces that Katyn and Eva were touching upon before lunch, how are we really documenting those changes in attitudes, and how are we actually getting the evidence base and those lessons learned so that we're actually incorporating that into our future interventions. We also felt that there were a lot of cross-cutting below. So what you see kind of in the lighter blue is there's a lot around the social sciences. So country engagement, we've talked a lot about that today, right? Policy drivers, motivators, barriers. We need to be able to document those. We need to document the success stories and understand what was the recipe that worked in that particular setting to get to for a country to get to control and elimination. Impact as well. So it does feed back a little bit into also measuring effectiveness, but you know, big things that come up, particularly for WASH, is what level of WASH coverage do we need to stop transmission? I mean, Guy was very straightforward with yesterday with the investment case, the 80%, you know, we're saying that's where we need to get. That's maybe not on a proven scientifically, maybe it's not 80%, maybe it's more, maybe it's less. But, you know, the idea is that we really need to hone in on that and understand it better. And then, of course, the bottom, I guess the bottom line, right, always comes down to money. So cost effectiveness and value for money. We really need to start to be able to also articulate that in the work that we're doing. So this came out in a report that was shared around with the GTFCC. If people here in the room didn't get the report from that meeting, we can make sure that you have it. This is just to set the scene to say this is the overall GTFCC research agenda. So this has been presented at the other working group meetings that have happened since July. So that's case management as well as OCV. So this is at least our attempt to show how we're working together and collectively through the pillars and at the different stages of how we're dealing with caller interventions. So specifically from that, we've had a small working group that had already been established of mainly academic researchers, as well as some of our colleagues from the regional platform and some implementing partners, doing kind of, you know, monthly calls more or less on research. And we decided to spend some time to really understand within the broad areas that I've just outlined here on the left of what are the broad components of the GTFCC research agenda, how do we as WASH specifically fit into that? And what we came up was actually six areas where we said these are the areas that we really want to focus on. It's not to say that there's not more, but we kind of thought, and I think the general feeling is there is such a need and so much evidence, so much gaps in evidence that if we don't prioritize, we might, you know, dilute it all and run off in too many directions all at the same time. So there was the decision to just say, let's look at six main areas and let's concretely start to really to work on these areas in terms of developing the evidence-based. So the first one is what actually Danielle just mentioned earlier, the commonly implemented, severely under-researched interventions that happen, particularly in the emergency response of caller interventions. So really trying to understand the effectiveness and the impact of those, particularly for the interventions that have no supporting evidence, and she listed some of those this morning. Also, as part of the how do we optimize the interventions, we're looking at the rapid response team. So again, this morning we did have the presentation about the key pieces and activities that were happening in Haiti and looking at the level of effectiveness of those rapid response teams. So again, how effective, how much impact can really targeted WASH interventions at the households be. Transmission dynamics, so this is back to the billion dollar question, the minimum WASH package. So what is it? What do we need to be doing? So there we say that's where we need case studies and that's where we need to create the evidence base, because likely, and I think we talked about this yesterday in the group one, It will never be one size fits all. The WASH part of it will be very contextual. So what worked in one country or one setting or one location may not exactly work the same way, but we can, and I think we discussed that this morning, can start to have some typologies, can start to see some trends and try to take learning from that. Synergies of intervention. So again, really bringing in the linkages between OCV and WASH and the timeliness and the effectiveness of the interventions. We spoke about this quite a bit at the OCV working group meeting in December, and really saying that, yes, while the overall package is very important and we have to have the medium, the long-term WASH, we can't forget about those large-scale investments. Even during those 5 days of a campaign and location, we need to be capitalizing on that time. We need to capitalize on that momentum, and we need to make sure that WASH is involved, that C4D, risk communications, and that we're not just kind of letting vaccinations happen over here and we're kind of doing something over there and really trying to bring that together. And so fortunately we got very positive feedback from the OCV working group, and they're very excited to work on that with us in 2019 to both define it and also potential for research. Behavior, practice, and improvements. We've talked a lot about that today and yesterday, really understanding what the motivators and what the barriers are. So a lot of the research that's already ongoing. Christine Marie presented the work that she's been doing, and there's other researchers that are also out there, like London School, Val's looking a lot at hand washing. So really the idea around that is we need to have much more documented evidence on that. And lastly, just the overall integrated health and WASH responses. So the more longer term programmatic learning, so particularly in countries that have reached elimination or control, what can we learn from them? What can we be advising countries? You know, Haiti, you're there, you're almost there, you know, so really just to get you over the finish line and make sure it stays that way. So these were the six areas that we said we would like to really focus on that, and we would really like that our partners focus on that as well. It's not to say that other research is not welcomed and interested in, it's just we really wanted to make sure that us as the working group were aligning also with the overall research agenda inside the GTFCC. So just making sure that we fit into the broader lines and that we also make those synergies with the other pillars or the other working groups. Last slide. So this is actually a supported piece of work, some funding that Carlos was actually mentioning earlier from the CDC to UNICEF to fund what we're calling the research plan. And basically, it would be about an 80-day piece of work over 6 months. It is really looking at how do we come upon a harmonized approach for how we're going to move forward these six areas. So we have actually developed the TOR and consulted with the small research group. Christine Marie's on that group. So we've had regular calls to kind of feedback. What are we actually trying to get out of this piece of work? But in principle, it's really to stock take a bit of all that ongoing research, some of it that we've seen this morning, where we are in the six areas, identify any additional knowledge gaps, also to think about the actual research plan, what type of questions are we actually wanting to ask within those six areas, what is the methodology, how do we outline this, and also to think a little bit about who is best placed to do what. We do see that recently, and we'll have a quick minute on the Wellcome and DFID Trust, sometimes calls for research come out, but it has a very short deadline and everybody scrambles a bit and well, who's going to submit what? And the idea was, could we also just better coordinate ourselves so that it was almost that idea I think that came up in group work too, these off the shelf or shovel projects, so that we've got the research ready to go and to just be put out there for funding. And that will also help us a bit with an advocacy plan and making sure that there are additional funds that are going to specifically support research, not just in cholera, but even further down, really focusing on WASH. And then, of course, all of that would need some sort of monitoring and accountability framework. So the idea is once we have this all in place, then every year at a forum like this, we update all of you as a working group to say, okay, we have now 3 ongoing research in this particular area, or, you know, we're about to have this funded. So we actually start to see where we were maybe lacking, or maybe where we needed to beef up, per se, certain areas. How well are we doing that? And is there interest? And if we do see that there's gaps in that, then that does go back to the advocacy and the fundraising, because maybe there's particular areas that we can particularly say, really, we need to understand better about the OCV WASH link, or is it the RRT? So that is the presentation. It was just to give a quick overview of what's happening with research. The consultancy is online. It has been advertised, actually, unfortunately, it was advertised over the holiday period of the end of the year, so there were not a lot of submissions, so we've gone ahead and extended that by 1 month, and it's now closing on the 24th of February. So please, if there's any interest in the room or colleagues that are of yours that aren't here with us in the room, do let us know, because we'd be very happy to make sure that they have access to where the published TOR and all the, what do we call it, tendering process, bidding process is online on the UN, the request for proposal, with the website, the UN.
We'll send the link.
Okay.